Hi all. In this video, let's look into how React use effect hook works. Before that, we need to learn what is a side effect, when does a use effect run, how to run the use effect on state and prop changes, and what is about the cleaning up the returning of cleaning up function. So let's see one by one. So firstly, what is a side effect? So in the programming language, side effect is not a negative word, but in a programming language, a side effect means we'll be having a procedure or a function which changes based upon a variable from the outside of its scope. So that is known as a side effect. That is how that is reflected in the use effect means. Use effect is also a function which is executed based upon the state changes or the prop changes which are out of its scope. So that's the reason we call use effect as a side effect. So let's see what all the sample examples of side effect. Fetching the data with the fetch or Axios third-party library is considered as a side effect. And also setting up the timers and intervals also considered as a side effect. And any manipulation we do on the DOM, like adding the events, modifying the title, any operations that we do on the DOM is considered as a side effect. So the people who is coming from the class components, who had developed earlier with the class components and lifecycle methods, for them this would be a bit useful. We can consider use effect as a alternative or replication for these lifecycle methods. Even it can do more than this. It means component did mount. It only runs when the component is initially mounted for first time. We can use effect like this. And component did update, it means for each and every update, every change, it can be run. And component will unmount means the component is going out of the scope. So in that case also, we can use this use effect with the cleaning up the effort function. So this is the replication of all these functions. Use effect is a replication of all these functions. So let's see one by one. So let me go to this. There's a sample application created with the create React app. So to use use effect, we need to import that from the React package. That's the first point we need to do. And the second point, the basic syntax of the use effect is this. You need to write a use effect and a callback function, not a callback function, it's a function. So here you'll be writing a function. So this is a default syntax of use effect. By default, this use effect will be executed for the first render and also for each and every update as well. So here I wrote a sample data fetch. So this is a sample fake API, JSON placeholder. I'm trying to fetch the API data. So this is a sample API. So let's see what happens in the browser. So initially when I render the page, you can see only I'm concentrating on this fetch call. So it was executed. So it means for the first render, when the use effect was executed, when the component is mounted, then at the first render, the API call was triggered. It means this function was executed. The code which is inside the use effect was executed. This is by default, use effect would be there. But if I click the change function as well, see, even I click this change function button, what I'm doing in this button, I'm just incrementing the state count value. In sense, I have taken a use state and a count variable. When I click the button, I am incrementing this count value. What instance, the component is re-rendered again. As on when I click the count, the state was updated. As the state is updated, the component is re-rendered. As the component is re-rendered, this use effect is again executed. So that's the reason you can see one more call here. Use effect call. So fetch call, one more fetch call was happened. So this is by default happens by the use effect. So what if you want only to achieve the component did mount, so the component mount, only if you want to execute the use effect when the component is mounted, then you need to use a second parameter called as dependency array. Usually we will be calling this as an empty array, but this is a dependency array. So what exactly happens is when you keep this dependency array, empty array, how this works internally means, so on mount of this component, this function would be executed. Later on, for each and every re-renders, this React will check this dependency array. Should I re-render Should I run this function again or not? As the dependency array is empty, it will find that there is no need for me to re-render again, because nothing was mentioned in this array, dependency array. Usually in this dependency array, we'll be mentioning about states or props values. Based upon the state value, if any state value was modified, accordingly this function would be executed. If any prop value is modified, accordingly that this function would be executed. As nothing was mentioned here, it will go into the sleep mode. Once it is executed on the component mount, the later on for every re-renders, it will verify this dependency array. As this is empty, it will not execute from the next re-renders. So that's the reason, if you want to execute any method or any functionality, if you want to execute when the component is mounting, then we need to use this second parameter as an empty array. This is a dependency array. Usually we call this as a dependency array. So this is how the use effect by default, how it works, and by how it works when the component is mounted. So now let's see how it works when the state is modified. So I'm using one more use effect. So use effect, I'm writing a function for use effect. I'm using the second parameter dependency array. I'm just here consoling state changed. So here I can mention the count value, because count is a state variable here. So here what I'm writing is, I'm writing an use effect where I'm asking to execute this function when the count value was updated. So that's the reason. If you see now, if I click plus symbol, this will be executed only once when the component is rendered. Now if I click the button, this function would be executed for us, because as on when I click the button, this state value would be modified. We are going to set the count. So in sense, we are modifying the state. So as on when the state is modified, this count variable would be modified. So in the dependency array, we have mentioned the count variable. In sense, for the next updates, use effect will check this dependency array. As this count variable is modified, it will execute this function. So this is how it works for the state changes as well. So let's see that. So I'm refreshing it one more time. So for the first time, it would be executed. And for the second time, so if I click this, it will not execute. We are not doing the fetch call again, because we have used the dependency array like this. So from now, the second call won't happen. Only the first call will be happen, because we have used this fetch on component mount, only once at the component mount. Now when I click the button, so let's see, when I click the button, if you click again, I'm clicking the button. When I click the button, the state has changed. So we are getting this function is executed for us, because we have modified the state changes as count. So in this way, we can execute the state changes with the use effect. So if here, this is an array. So here you can mention any number of things, like you can mention one more state variable or one more property variable as well. But ideally, the good thing is, like if you want to have the changes independently, individually, like if related code should be used in a use effect. So use effect can be used multiple times. This is not only once or twice like that. Based upon the state changes, when this count changes, what you need to do. So that logic should be relevant here. So in a similar way, when the props changes, then you can use one more use effect like this. So let me use one more use effect. So, and here now you can keep any prop changes. If the props were changed, this method would be executed. So let's give some props here. So we have app here. So how to give props to the app? So just I'm giving a props. So the component which is using this app component should be responsible to send the props. So that's the reason I'm going here. So index.js is a file which is using the props. So just I'm sending a name. Okay, I'm sending a name. So index.js is using the app component. We are sending a property to app.js component. Now this props will receive the name property. So based upon this props dot, so I'm using this props dot name. So based upon whenever we receive any props, new props, so then this would be modified. So whenever the prop is changed, in the parent component, then also this method would be executed. In this way, we need to divide our use effect. This can be used multiple times based upon our logic. Whenever the prop is modified, if you want to do any business logic, then you can do that in this function. And you can, whenever the state is modified, that you can do in this function. So you can keep the relevant code like this. Whenever the state changes, that relevant code goes here. Whenever the prop changes, that goes here. So also you can do like this as well, as I said. So you can give an array of values if they are relevant to this function. So let's see. Now the props, if the any prop was modified in the parent component, now this, as this is a child, this component would be triggered and this props as modified. So this function would be executed once again. So let me show you that. So as on when the prop was received, this function would be executed. So now even I'm changing the state, only the state changed use effect is executing, not the props changed, because at the parent level, prop is not modified. If anything is modified at the index.js level and which impacted this property, then this would be re-rendered. This app component would be re-rendered and this prop name would be modified. So that's the reason this function would be executed. So this is how the use effect would be running whenever the state changes or the prop changes happens. So the last point is regarding the cleanup function. So this cleanup function is by default. This is an optional function which is provided by use effect. Usually why we use this cleanup function means, so for example, if you have a requirement to open the socket, so there would be two communications like HTTP communication and socket communication as well. So if you open the socket communication, okay, to an endpoint, and if you forgot to close this socket, so what happens, there would be a memory leakages. So that's the reason it's better to use effect like cleanup functions like this. So that once the component is used and the component is unmounted, then it's our responsibility to close that resource so that there won't be any memory leakages. So this is an optional thing, cleanup function, but we need to use this whenever we are using some resources like socket like this. We need to use this whenever the component is unmounted. We can disconnect that socket. In that way, we can avoid the memory leakages. Usually there would be some other scenarios to use this as well, cleanup function. In the cases like if you are doing any chatbot chatting, so once the chatting was done, that session was completed, it's good to clean up that chat in order to avoid the information leak or memory leaks as well. So in order to clean up the memory as well, you can clean up that chat. So that's the reason you can use this cleanup function as well. So this is how you need to use. So here you will be doing whatever you want to do when in the initial load. So when the component is unmounting, in sense you are removing this component from the DOM, this function, this is a cleanup function. We call this as a cleanup function. So you're just returning, you need to return a function and you need to mention what you are going to do in this function. So here I'm mentioning to close, to disconnect the socket. In this way, the socket would be disconnected. You can avoid the memory leakages. Remember, this function we need to use to clean up the resources. So this is all about what is a use effect, what is a side effects, and how the state changes and the prop changes, how the use effect will react to the state and prop changes, and about the cleanup function as well. So hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.